daughter of finality, the sister of apocalypse, the wife of extinction, the priestess of rape, the mother of despair, and the seductress of deception.
I am the Nilotic, a pansexual cross-dressing rapper, MC, and an all-around artist. But I'm also a film director. Recently graduated from Tribeca Flashpoint, downtown Chicago in the Loop. Directed various short films and also music videos for other artists. I'm currently working on shooting some music videos for some of my new songs from my new album, Lullabies for a Lifestyle, which will be out very soon and everyone should check it out.
Trapped in my spiral cage, I see things I wish didn't exist, but I keep a list of those I created here and insist.
Technically, in this world, possessing every girl that I meet in these haunted halls, I stretch my arm through my bars and touch the breathing walls. Then the shrieking call breaks forth through my throat and stalls my memory from revealing my escape from this cage as I crawl toward the wall. A drizzle of fresh mucus, come join us through this doorway and kiss me forever in this death landscape. The only way to stay. He is evil, uncivil, never shrivel up like clay. Pay for your sins, with him singing me with his my cage finally open. And step through the straight door down, give me the monster.
This is my false reality. Only the fallen are what's real, where the lie is the truth and the truth is a lie.
What have you heard about the Nilotic?
The Nilotic?
Yes.
You're at your beginning stages, so it's pretty cool to see all your songs and whatnot that you're churning out like a factory.
So I had a t-shirt made to promote Messiah Complex. Just came in the mail. Let's see what it looks like. Alright, there's a giant 7 on the front, on the back, it says Nilotic, part of my poem, and then on the bottom it says Messiah Complex. It's pretty badass.
Shoot me into the sun and watch me burn to ashes, then watch me rise then out the dirt. Cannot die till I am God. tell me what it means to be all the things that I can be and all the things that are not me. I am on your crooked tree. Tell me what it means to be all the things that I can be and all the things that are not me. I am on your crooked tree. Can you stop me before I crack the life support? Superficial existence, I have no use for that. And I know that I have a statement if I felt that it's worth saying. From all your fears, I'll cover up all of your tears. Tie me down and then they'll shoot me. But trust me, then come we'll see. The world that now I will destroy will crumble now, so like a toy. Tell me what it means to be all the things that I can be and all the things that are not me. I am on your crooked tree. I'll scream it till my throat is bleeding. This is all I think I'm needing. Hear me in my all forgotten. You say he gave his only begotten Son for this dying world. Why save what's already damned? What's my competition? You confirm my speculation. I don't need more information from your female masturbation. Only reason that I'm here is to make you all my puppets. Subjection is an art, and soon you'll know my face. Tell me what it means to be all the things that I can be and all the things that are not me. I am on your crooked tree. We rejected him as they rejected me, but from the altar of sin, this is what I see.
I'm not gonna hit a girl, but I'll choke the bitch out, tie her to her chair, and hang her outside the window.
I'll choke the bitch out.
You owe me some fucking money for a hard drive, bitch.
Please let me come over here, hang her outside of a window.
You're only on the fifth floor. That can't hurt that bad. Fuck that, dude. I'll take her up to the roof.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry! Oh, change, I swear to god!
Alright.
Swear to god, you take him out of context, I will cut your hair bald and then scratch your scrotum with this, and it's pretty fucking dull. Got it?
I don't like to limit myself to one type of thing because a lot of people are just known as like a filmmaker or a recording artist and whatnot, but I like to make music. That's what I'm really focused on right now, but I'm a writer by nature, so I write poetry, I write short stories, working on some novels actually.
Interesting.
I paint and I draw too, so, and also I graduated from film school, so I'm also a filmmaker. So I try to dabble in as much as I can.
I rose from off of the doctor's slab. I lost a piece of my heart. Gets to take a stab. They cut me up into parts. I gave a piece to my mother. gave a piece to the rock star. He took the good stuff and ran.
I tell you, an old man had ascended up to heaven, but he that came down, even the Son of Man, which is, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so was the Son of Man, that whosoever believeth should not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
So what do we come here to do, Dave?
We came Nilotic. To destroy things.
How are we going to do that, man? How are you going to destroy things?
Weapons of mass destruction.
So what do you got planned for everybody?
World domination.
Alright, that's what's up. This is real. What's good, Scheme?
I'm chilling. Those are like real nice answers, my man gave to you.
See Alice's body lying on the floor, contort the way the world looks through the door, pouring from her chest, rivers of blood, slivers of a flood, but not burying the mud strip naked that exposed to the air. She's got no more despair, but aware of this affair. Right then when you stare, I tear a gash up and down her heart, leave a rash where her body tears apart. She was pregnant with a weapon, so come in when I wreck it. Just a second, I'll give a forced abortion. Go ahead and watch my films of exploitation of audience and actor. Lose friends and detractor. There will always be an Alice, but only one Nilotic. Never-ending Alice. There will always be an Alice, but only one Nilotic. Never-ending Alice. Never-ending Alice!
So weird.
I do think that your lyrics are gonna get some uproar out of some people, in a good and bad way, I think.
But what juices to drip from your vagina? Is it daisies or black menstrual blood?
These are all informants laying dormant till the days were cursed of tribulation. What you see before you is no left behind simulation. Our homes have become our fallout shelters, helters, scutterwits, terrified of one another. Trust no one in your neighborhood. Father wears an executioner's hood. We all live alone, tethered to the stone. Isolation inside your head, cut off until you're dead.
Life sucks.
Really?
Yeah.
So why don't you kill yourself?
I might actually.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How would you do it? Would it be a fun way?
Can't be so lucky I chose not to become a killer. I chose to be a killer.
I was born and raised in the Chicago area, but there's a lot of baggage and dark times in my history that happened in Chicago, so I kind of wanted to get away from that after I graduated from film school. I moved, actually I'm living in Providence, Rhode Island now.
I've got my things back, my favorite pillow, got my sleeping bag, climb out the window. All the pictures and pain I've left behind, all the freedom and fame I've gotta find. And I wonder how long it'll take them to notice that I'm gone. And I wonder how far it'll take me to run away, run away, run away, run away. I was just trying to be myself. Give it your way, I'll meet you.
tapestry. Big red light dancer in New Orleans. I could start again, choose a family. I could change my name, come and go as I please. In the dead of night, wonder where I've gone. Wasn't it you?
So I kind of needed to go somewhere where I could get away from all the bullshit that that happened in my life back in Chicago.
I've been rapping since I was like 13 years old, all thanks to Eminem when he came out with the Eminem Show. My parents allowed me to get it, but only the censored version, which kind of pissed me off because they didn't even have drips on there, not even a censored version. They had to take the whole song out because it was too explicit. But that didn't stop me from getting the uncensored version like a week later from one of my schoolmates who just burned me a copy. I got the uncensored version. But anyway, so that's when I just started writing rhymes. You know, I was like 13. It like sparked my my inspiration for writing and a whole new level of poetry.
A lot of the friends that hung out with, like, listened to hip hop, they kind of introduced me to it. But I don't know, back then I was kind of like more discovering it more as a connection with my friends. So I would just listen to like whatever they would listen to or whatever, you know, like I was introduced to some Tupac back then, and more mainstream stuff back then a little bit, I guess. I don't remember a lot of it that I listened to, but back then I was introduced to 3-6 Mafia.
Motherfucking suckers up in here playing these motherfucking games, man. Ain't nothing but a whole ass nigga, man. You know it. Put your finger in this motherfucking fire.
Hey, man, what's up with y'all?
Back, man, and tell that nigga you up.
Oh. Yeah, nigga, I was just getting my dick sucked by the neighborhood hoe. Y'all, man, this is my home, man. Y'all holla at your boy. This is Cherry Pie. We got Juicy C. You know, it's the most unknown unknowns, man. It's all good. We got the DVD coming out, Adventures in Suburban Hood.
I was into hip hop for a little bit in high school, but then it kind of fell off, and I kind of hated hip hop for a few years because of the new 3-6 Mafia music that they're putting out.
Wow.
Because they were like my favorite group, you know, because I first started listening to like Mystic Styles and their old stuff, which I really like. But then when they put out like Most Known Unknown and Last to Walk, that kind of killed my love of hip hop.
We got the beats pumping out. We got everything good, man. But, you know, we gotta push the album back. It's not coming out till 2012, but it's all good because, you know, our quality is stepping up. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's called Last to Crawl. Remember, it's going to be in stores December of 2012, okay? Remember to pick it up. Pick it, the 2-disc platinum edition. We're going to have the funky-ass new cardboard covers because that shit is all popping the hinges. You know what I'm saying? The new record companies.
You know, if this is how the music industry is going to go and, you know, this is how hip-hop's going to go, I don't know if I want to be part of it.
Yeah. This is your boy Cherry Pie. Holla at your boy. I forgot to tell you one thing. We got the new website up with all merchandise. We got, it's called Dangerous Scamminess. That's www.drangerousscamndlusc.com. And we got t-shirts, we got shoes, we got shorts, you know, we got everything. We got the new out, we got special edition songs remixed by Juicy J and DJ Paul. We got everything. We got the shoes. We got everything. We got Last the Crawl coming out 2012 December. Okay, be there at the store at midnight. You know, me and my boys are gonna be out at Hot Topic signing shit, because we got the new clothing, like spike bracelets, spike chains, collars. We got all that shit. We got leashes. You gotta buy the most unknown leashes. You know, you gotta keep that neighborhood O on the chain. You know, that's right. But this is my hood right here. Everything is good. It's good, nigga. We gotta keep it good, keep it fresh, keep everything good. Last to crawl, nigga. This is Cherry Pie. I'm out.
And it wasn't until years later that I discovered Sage Francis, and that he really opened the door back up for me to get into hip hop, and it showed me that there was, you know, lyricism and talent and ability that could be shown through the art form of hip hop, not just what the media is broadcasting you, mm-hmm. you know, on BET and MTV and shit like that.
This is dedicated to Shoeless over there.
Yeah.
So everybody knows.
I know that guy. What do you know?
Whereas breakbeats have been the missing link connecting the diaspora community to its drum woven past. Whereas the quantized drum has allowed the whirling mathematicians to calculate the ever-changing distance between rock and stardom. Whereas the velocity of spinning vinyl cross-faded, spun backwards, and re-released at the same given moment of recorded history has allowed history to catch up with the present. We do hereby declare reality unkept by the changing standards of dialogue. Statements such as, keep it real, especially when punctuating articulating modes of ultraviolence, inflicted psychologically or physically, or depicting an unchanging rule of events, will henceforth be seen as retroactive and not representative of the individually determined is. Furthermore, as determined by the collective consciousness of this state of being and the lessened distance between thought patterns and their secular manifestations, the role of men as listening receptacles is to be increased by number no less than 70% of the current enlisted as vocal aggressors. Motherfuckers better realize, now is the time to self-actualize. We have found evidence that hip-hop standard 85 RPM, when increased by at least half the rate of the standard, or decreased by 3/4 its speed, may be a determining factor in heightening consciousness. Studies show that when a given norm is changed in the face of the unchanging, the remaining contradictions will parallel the truth. Equate rhyme with reason, sun with season. Our cyclical relationships and phenomena has encouraged scholars to erase the centers of periods, thus symbolizing the nonlinear character of cause and effect. Reject mediocrity. Your current frequencies of understanding outweigh that which has been given for you to understand. The current standard is the equivalent of an adolescent restricted to the diet of an infant. The rapidly changing body would acquire dysfunctional and deformative symptoms and could not properly mature on a diet of applesauce and crushed pears. Light years are interchanged with years of living in darkness. The role of darkness is not to be seen as or equated with ignorance, but with the unknown and the mysteries of the unseen. Thus, in the name of Robeson, Godson, Hurston, Akhenaten, Ashetsput, Blackfoot, Helen, Lenin, Kahlo, Kali, the Three Marias, Tara, Lilith, Lord, Whitman, Baldwin, Ginsberg, Kaufman, Lumumba, Gandhi, Gibran, Shabazz, Siddhartha, Medusa, Guevara, Gurdjieff, Rand, Wright, Banneker, Tubman, Hamer, Holiday, Davis, Coltrane, Morrison, Joplin, Du Bois, Clark, Shakespeare, Rachmaninoff, Ellington, Carter, Gay,
Hendrix, Cootie, Dickerson, Ripperton, Mary, Isis, Teresa, Platt, Rumi, Fellini, Michaud, Nostradamus, Nefertiti, LaRock, Shiva, Ganesha, Yamaya, Oshun, Obatala, Ogun, Kennedy, King, Four Little Girls, Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Keller, Biko, Perone, Marley, Shakur, Those Who Burn, Those Still Aflame, and the countless unnamed. We claim the present as the present, as the hereafter. We are unraveling our navel so that we may ingest the sun. We are not afraid of the darkness. We trust that the moon shall guide us. We are determining the future at this very moment. We now know that the heart is a philosopher's stone. Our music is our alchemy. We stand as a manifest equivalent of three buckets of water and a handful of minerals, thus realizing that those very buckets turned upside down supply the percussive factor of forever. If you must count to keep the beat, then count. Find your mantra and awaken your subconscious. Carve your circles counterclockwise. Use your cipher to decipher coded language, man-made laws, climb waterfalls and trees, commune with nature, snakes and bees. Let your children name themselves and claim themselves as the new day. For today, we are determined to be the channelers of these changing frequencies into songs, paintings, writings, dance, drama, photography, carpentry, crafts, love, and love. We enlist every instrument, acoustic, electronic, every so-called race, gender, sexual preference, every person as beings of sound to acknowledge their responsibility to uplift the consciousness of the entire fucking world. Any utterance unnamed will be disclaimed, will be maimed, two rappers slain.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good night, night. Channeling Solomon's coded language. That was motherfucking hot, dude. Give it up for the Nile Addict once again. There are many times when you hear a cover, well, Ben Harper told me don't call them covers, call them reinterpretations. There's many times that you hear a reinterpretation of a song or a poem and you're like, oh, that's nice. He fucking stole that shit. Saul, I'm talking to you.
Yes.
He just jacked your shit, money.
Yes.
You just got served with your own piece, money.
Damn.
I love Saul Williams. I kid.
Yes.
Amethyst rock star indeed.
So the last question is, what are your thoughts on David Sherry?
What?
David Sherry.
Okay.
Right. Don't ask that.
Okay. Great. Now, what are your thoughts on David Sherry?
Mr. Sherry. Mr. Sherry's a character and a half. I don't know that many people like him. Yeah.
You don't have to answer that.
Why do you keep fucking asking?
It's on the paper.
I didn't write that.
Because there's nothing there to insulate. So it's just like, you know, I go out to listen.
Battle cry, fall now, tell me how the cow speaks of better days, I'll say you'll know the truth. We go back to a tooth for a tooth, we go back to a tooth for a tooth. Believe in the soothsayers and the way I say slayers. Never take candy from an infant. To them, you're an elephant, so don't take their virginity. I love that smell, tell me of serenity.
Well, what does the Nilotic represent to you?
What does it represent?
I think it represents, like, everything that, like, maybe society doesn't want to see, doesn't want to pay attention to, you know? That's what I feel like you bring, you put a mirror in front of, you know, society's face, and it's kind of what I see in your, you know, your style.
When I say I'm a pansexual cross-dressing rapper, what I mean is I simply don't see people as just male or female. I see them as just human. I'm interested in people. And obviously cross-dressing, I'm another Ed Wood, man.
Sage Francis is definitely one of my biggest influences in the hip-hop genre. But I take influence from lots of different genres and lots of different types of art, not just music. I'm very influenced by performance art, and a lot of the MCs that I do like are also performance artists, like B. Dolan. I really love B. Dolan, who's also on Sage Francis' record label, Strange Famous. And I'm also a big fan of Immortal Technique and those types of MCs. But I also get inspiration from rockers, because I listen to rock music and lots of different types of music, some folk music, not a lot of folk music, but some. And like Marilyn Manson is one of my favorite artists of all time. So I really get a lot of my inspiration for what I do from things that I love about Marilyn Manson and things that I love about Sage Francis, and see what I can do with bringing some of the things that I like that Marilyn Manson does, but bring it into like a hip hop setting and see what kind of things stir up in that way.
Now tonight! Woo! Will, before we do this song, tell them a little bit about it.
Oh, this over here, get off that nigga's nuts. This dude's got an obsession with Marilyn Manson and Sage Francis. I don't know if you guys know who they are, but everybody knows who Marilyn Manson is. But this is his song right here, and I tell him, get off of that nigga's nuts with his obsession ass.
Oh, yeah?
Get rid of this right here, y'all. It will.
All right, let's get into this. Yeah. In the street, I resemble my idol, but I'm no longer suicidal. Come follow my titles, so we never get a cycle. First time I heard it, I was not yet a fan. Those already planned for his philosophy to enter my world with the loud of a little girl singing. You look like Marilyn Manson, I'm sure, but they're that. Was a god of little parents, so I said, is that good? I think fans is sexy, come fetch me, such a less free. Hold up, I'm being testy. Danny created a monster by giving me a book, which led me to a poster. It's a long, hard road that I held. Good morning to the swell. Well, I don't work with any stars, but I love when these other scars. Yeah.
My bag.
So as we fly flags of authentic aesthetics that bring death to my skeptics, we do need some controversy, but first we will head out. Yeah.
Get off that nigga's back.
All right.
No.
Get off the man's nuts.
LLB.
It will. Ha! Ha! Nilotic. All right. You guys are awesome.
Yeah.
It will. Get over. It will.
That was awesome.
For sure.
We won a battle.
Yes.
This is gonna end up on the internet.
Don't even put this on the fucking internet. I'll be heated at you.
I'm not opposed to doing collaborations with other people. I do work with a producer right now who's called Ill Will, who's been making beats for me. But
all right.
His sound definitely correlates with what I'm trying to do, which is really good.
I'm Ill Will. I'm from Providence, Rhode Island. Well, East Providence, technically. My usual sound for hip-hop is I try to make it old school. Like, I try to use actual drums and snares. I don't like using synths, claps, 808s, and all that. Unless I'm making it for, like, a slow type beat, you know, like the R&B beat or something like that. But for sounds, for hip-hop, I usually make like a darker, mysterious vibe.
Back in Chicago, I never found anyone that made beats that wanted to work with me. So coming out to Rhode Island, I found someone, so that was pretty cool.
Tell me when you hit the ground to make a sound as if you didn't know you're hellbound. Why'd you buy that rope if you wasn't gonna tie me? Why'd you buy those condoms if you wasn't gonna lay me? Tame the ground running, sing the sound gunning, frame the round drumming. I want your blood as I strip down, leave it to murder cases, see you drown, blown away by fathers not there, stare into the sun as if you didn't care.
Yeah, I like to switch up my sound a lot and not make the same type of things. I make harder stuff, lighter stuff, more underground. I've made a couple songs that are on a beat that would be considered more poppy, but like dark pop. So I would make music in other genres. I don't like to limit myself to one genre. Like I said, I don't limit to one form of art. I also don't limit to one genre of music. I don't like the genres that divide music, you know, in such a way. I really am not a fan of labels and putting labels on anything. So it's like, I mean, they serve a purpose where it's like, oh, you gotta categorize me in hip-hop, but that's not all of what I do. That doesn't describe everything that I am.
Speaking sincerely on this railroad no bound, my mother listens but says everything with no sound. I said I wouldn't make apologies for myself, but I'm sorry for the tears to which I offer no help. Just melt into the platform aimed for heaven. You don't understand why I'm becoming seven. Heaven leaves your face as leaven rises to the skies in mountainous lies. Defeat my insignificance and mask my utter ignorance as I film the world we don't see. All of it, all of it, all of it is me, but the mirrors through your cheeks flee from the fact that what we see is only half the picture. This is not a power lecture that fills as a spade does with hair. My incessant speech spit dampen your stare. I'll make apologies to my sister. We don't speak, look, I haven't kissed her. Shut your lips, suppress your hips, pull off the clips. I sink into the mother's teeth, that's the one to decide to keep. Rejected, eluded son, he's become a bomb. Outbound train from Millennium Station. Chest death kills in anticipation. Fuck my life, I live in cremation. I thought I dropped it, but stay temptation. Why would I want to save a world that rejects me? Anger injects and slowly infects me, scarring the land and ejecting the free. So I suffer in noise with no secret I'm into boys or that I enjoy these kind of toys. But you only think the world is dark because your eyes are shut. I am the dead king and the killer of last things, becoming stuck, becoming seven, but walking backwards through the muck. Life's not a rehearsal, it's the whole fucking show. I throw myself at a world with no eyes for me. The empty sockets of popularity bend to ignore me. I give you my body so you can play with my breath. I give you my life so you can play with my death. Sex isn't everything, but everything is sex. Please help me discard this messiah complex. Outbound train for Millennium Station. Chest death kills in anticipation. Fuck my life, I live in cremation. I thought I dropped it, but stayed temptation. I don't want to be remembered for the way that I die. I want to be remembered for the way that I live. She never had the heart to point out my delusion. I wallow in prehistory, experiencing cry illusions. Why didn't you tell me my life wasn't the edge of a knife? Babbling, dabbling, candlestick betwixt one realm of hate broken through the gate. And I finally come to grips before I board into infinity. I have failed you, plugged up Earth's sewer, I'm no trinity. But the struggle isn't between destroying or saving the world. It's between destroying or saving myself. Thank you.
What are your future plans?
Take over the world.
Nice one.
No, actually, I have lots of future plans and ambitions that, you know, high goals and dreams. You know, everyone needs to have dreams. That's what keeps us going in life. And a few of my dreams are to, you know, start up my own independent record label called Apocalyptic Rhymes. Where I can put out my own music and maybe other people's music who maybe wouldn't be put out on another record label because they're too weird or too dark or some shit like that. Also, you know, making lots of stuff. So yeah, lots of stuff in the works. The end of the world is coming soon, and we need to open our eyes and see what the fuck is going on. Don't blind yourselves. Don't inebriate yourselves. Apocalyptic Rhymes. We write about the end times. Peace.
Satnam. I'm trying to get out of nature, and there's a Sony Pictures banner right over there. Ironic, isn't it? You can't get away from it. Except I got a beautiful tree in the background. Adais tise adais. Ad anio anad anahat juga juga eko vase. Adais tise adais. Ad anio anad anahat juga juga eko vase. Adais tise adais, ad anil anad anahat juga juga eko vase. I'm not saying that I know it all, but I'm pretty damn close.
All right, this is a piece I actually wrote on the way over here, so it's really rough, but here you go. I am continually dying among the living, and I find myself living among the dead. However, my mother is among the living, and my father is amongst the dead. And then there comes me, the one who doesn't belong, you see. So I scream in silence as the violence of unridden hopes pummel my body with their noise. Swimming in the sediment, I wait for the sky to accept the girls and boys that I have made love to. What is to come? What is to come for me? What is to come for you? And what is to come for all of us? For we are all of the same spirit as we remain prisoners of the never-ending crimson pendulum that pulled from the cave of ba-dum-dum-dum. I still feeling the ripples of the bomb, ba-dum-bum-bum. Please, I beg you to stretch your hand out to suddenly connect with the electricity pulsing from my palm. Where has this power come from? Pour the soul into me from the sun and the galaxies in every hand I've ever touched and every hand that's ever touched me. Push my hair back to reveal a hidden door to my mind. Open that door so the tales of iguanas can air themselves and combine with the thoughts that are brought forth from my sleeping fortifications. Motherfuckers need to look into my eyes so as to share my hallucinations that come not from drugs, but from the goddesses, the gods, the heart, the spirit, the love, the hate, the words, the humans, the subhumans, the superhumans, the mortals, and the immortals. I am one of them. I am all of them. Thank you.
Give it up for the Nihilotic, everyone!
Apocalypse. From Chicago to Arcata, all over the country, this hip-hop right here.